We're back on NASCAR Race Hub, and it's the water cooler talk of the day. Noah Gragson, Todd Gilliland going at it. Final lap at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. Open the door for that guy, Justin Haley, to get the win. So now that things have kind of calmed down, here's what Todd Gilliland tweeted. I've watched it so many times. If I would have gave him room, he still probably would have hit me, but that would have been my best bet. Hard to think about what's right and wrong when you have 1 second to think about it. And that's what got me to going back to 2014. You had Ryan Blaney or Mon Quiroga. It was almost premeditated for Blaney, who lets Quiroga get by. Then the crossover, he wins the race back to the checkered flag. That is how you do it on a road course in the final lap. Let's go next level with Sunday's festivities. Casey, here's the image that we're going to remember from 2018 in this race. What happens here, and how do you handle this as a driver as we take a look?
Well, I mean, right here, you can see they're both coming the last couple corners. Right here, Todd gets just a little bit loose. Right here, you can see the back of the truck just skip out just a little bit. You know that Noah's already thinking, how am I going to get around him in this last corner? And when he sees that, it gives him extra incentive to even pounce a little harder.
Do you process things a little bit differently, knowing that you are competing with your teammate in this circumstance?
Sure.
So let's watch it. As the tape rolls, you're going to see, I don't know that I would say the door opens, but certainly there is some room here. Should Todd have closed down more?
Well, I mean, he could have came in here a little tighter, but you already seen him make that move. When he got loose, he already started going back to the right just a little bit to close that door. And as you can see, I mean, Noah's right up on the curb. I mean, he didn't leave much of room open there. And he knew that Noah was probably going to come in and dive him, you know. And at the same time, he kind of goes, ooh, that's my teammate. Maybe I can crowd him a little bit and not worry about it, you know. So obviously both these guys playing some head games, and when it happens in a split of a second, a fraction of a second, I mean, it's so hard to make the right call.
The thought did cross my mind that Noah makes the move, and then it's like, oh my gosh, I'm in here, and we're teammates, and now what do I do?
Yeah.
And this is the end result. Neither one of them win the race.
And quite honestly, if the roles were reversed a little bit and Todd maybe wasn't, you know, Noah's teammate, Noah probably would have made the decision to go ahead and just take him out early and go on and win the race. But I think Noah did all he could do not to take his teammate out, and in turn took them both out. Todd didn't do anything wrong here. He was just doing the best job he could to win this race. There wasn't a whole lot else that he could do. Obviously, we watched that clip with Ryan Blaney, and that was an option, you know, is but he would have had to let him go and then do a crossover move, and you don't want to give up the lead going into last corner like that.
The guy that benefits, no doubt about it, Justin Haley, who many thought making his first playoff appearance would have a hard time advancing. Forget about it. He's in the round of six with his victory yesterday. You see the difference for all those other drivers. It is tied at the cut line. Anybody's guess who will move on to round number two.